you have some tools. I think that now you are with Alegria already, but okay. My name is Natasha Salima. I come from Politecnico of Porto, and I have started this PhD program 1 year ago. I'm enrolled in a partial time, so I'm just in the first phase of this project. The provisional title is Learning from Complementary Ways of Developing Experimental Competencies, and I'm going to start. I'm going to start to explain the context and motivation for this work. You all know, or at least everybody from engineering areas know that it is very important in engineering to develop experimental competencies. And these competencies were developed traditionally in laboratories, hands-on laboratories, regular laboratories. But last decades, there was a general growth in the number of students in higher education. And plus, with the volume process, the number of students per class increased and the lifetime was reduced. Among them, at the same time, the technologies have been developed and there are remote labs and simulations that allow the students to experiment this developing of these competencies in a different way. So nowadays, and although there is some controversy about the efficacy of these new technologies, research says that these technologies are quite effective, and as a matter of fact, it is clear that these new technologies make students have more better learning outcomes, or at least equal than traditional technologies. So a blended or hybrid approach is being advanced. So a combination of all these resources. Non-traditional resources like remote laboratories and simulations plus traditional resources allows the development of better competencies. So, when teachers are using all these resources, they must be aware that each resource allows the development of different competencies. So, tests should be defined according to it. And as teachers use more resources, and because all students have different learning styles, they can reach more students using all these resources. In the literature, there are some experiences that describe the use of these resources, the use of simultaneous resources, but they are small-scaled, and there are no significant differences, at least consistent differences, between hands-on simulation and remote labs. So, what we want to understand is this difference and try to explain a little better this. So, the remote lab that we are going to use is very busy. It's one of the most used laboratories, remote laboratories in engineering education. You can see here an image of Vizir, and it's a laboratory that had started in 1999 in Sweden, but it was just launched in 2004. And now it's used by several countries in Europe, and also here in Spain. And you can see here an image of that remote laboratory. And it's a laboratory for creating, wiring, and measuring electronic circuits. On that second image, you can see what a print screen of the PC when the student enters the remote lab. So you can see it can be considered a remote workbench with a breadboard and the components so that the students can practice like if they were in the laboratory itself. So this laboratory is now being used for thousands of students, for more than 4,400 of students. And in most cases, this resource was used on its own and not used simultaneously with others. So what we want to say, or what we want to understand, is the differences in the different resources. Recently, 1 year ago, it was being launched a project which is named Vizir Plus. And this project, which is a consortium between the European countries that use Vizir and Brazil and Argentina, aims to do a set of education models comprising hands-on simulation and Vizir remote lab together with campus, using a learning methodology based on inquiry. And within this project, and the data that is working with this project, I will try to develop my work. So, the problematic that is here is to understand how Visir has been used so far and what are the results that are nowadays. So, I started with the structural literature to understand and systemize what has been done so far. I found out that there are mainly two research areas using Visir: technical issues and tactical issues. My interest is in tactical issues. This work has been presented to Tim, track throughout educational innovation, and that has been presented yesterday. And the problem statement is to understand which and how students' learning outcomes are affected by the use of these different resources simultaneously in classes and also in assessments using this kind of methodology, an inquiry-based methodology. We are going to do this, applying this to several different contexts, trying to see if there are differences between AC and DC circuits, and explore other factors that may compromise students' engagement. So, the research questions that I have in this thesis are three. In which way the use of these simultaneous resources applying an inquiry-based teaching and learning methodology contributes to promote students' autonomous continual work and engagement? The second question is the level of competence under development affects students' enrollment in using the different resources? And the third question is, are there teacher mediation choices by using these resources that can be linked to better student performance? From what we are going to apply a case study methodology using a mixed approach methods. The case will be teachers and students from the courses where this methodology is going to be applied. We have several institutions from Brazil and from Argentina. Here are the main five, but there are more. The data that will be collected will be quantitative data, but also qualitative. The number of exams, interviews, questionnaires, and so on. The systematic literature review that has been performed so far made us conclude several things that are important for the beginning of this work. Is that Visir is a functional and useful learning instrument. It can be used to complement hands-on or as a tool for distance learning, increases students' confidence in lab, their enthusiasm and motivation, improves student competencies and knowledge, and is well accepted by students. There have been identified some factors that compromise students' engagement, and these are the teacher supervision when students use Visir first time because it's a new resource, as some questions that if students don't understand them immediately, they may drop the task and don't feel so enthusiastic. Is the teacher's attention to the Visir along the semester and the final contribution of Visir resource to the final grades. The first data will be obtained in February 2017. We'll start to analyze it all that time. There are two papers, one that has been already published 2 weeks ago, and that won the best prize in this project. One is going to be very soon in this month. And what we expect with this work is to further nurture the research around Visir and to promote and stimulate the use of this resource that we consider quite useful. And that's all. I'm sorry for the time.